Hey guys, what's up? It's me, Abs, and today we're going to talk about the GTX 970 and how it performs. Also, we're going to talk about the problem that many people had with the video memory of GTX 970. The card we'll be testing is the Asus Strix GTX 970, a 4GB video card. Does it really have 4GB of video memory? Well, more on that later. Let's have a look on the Asus Strix card. If you don't know what Strix means, well, it means owl in Greek. The coolest feature of the Asus card is a 0 dB fan technology that turns the fan off until the card is put into great stress or the temperature reaches a certain point. So it's great for silent operation. Also, the Asus cards have great overclocking capabilities. Now let's take a look at the specifications of the reference GTX 970 and compare it with the reference GTX 980. As you can see, the base clock speed and the CUDA cores are higher for the GTX 980. Also, the texture units are higher for the GTX 980. But there has been an update of the specifications. The specifications that were released earlier are not the exact specifications of the GTX 970. The render output units on the GTX 970 were updated as 56, which at the start was declared as 64, which its bigger brother GTX 980 had. Also, the GTX 970 has 1792 KB of L2 cache, where the GTX 980 has 2048 KB. Other specifications are quite similar with its bigger brother. The lower base clock is taken care of by the Asus card, and the base clock in the Asus GTX 970 is higher than the GTX 980 reference model. Now let's dive straight into its performance. If you want to know more about the card, then I'll leave a link in the description. The GTX 970 was a game killer at 1080p, so benchmarking it in 1080p would have been an insult to what it is capable of. So let's do the benchmarks in 1440p this time. The games we'll be testing are Battlefield 4, Metro Last Light, Tomb Raider, Bioshock Infinite. Let's take a look at the test system. The games were tested in Intel Core i7-4770K overclocked to 4.2 GHz, MSI G97 motherboard, Crucial Ballistics port RAM 16 GB. The latest Nvidia drivers was also installed. Now let's go to benchmarks. Here we go. The GTX 970 really impressed me. It performs way better than the previous GTX 770 and stacks up close to GTX 780. And from AMD's side, it even beats the R9290x in some games at 1440p. This card has the best price performance ratio according to me. Almost all the games ran at decent frame rates at 1440p. So if you're going to play games on 1080p, then this card will be a game killer in high settings and all the anti-aliasing turned up. And I am not talking about the poor optimized games Ubisoft made like Assassin's Creed Unity. The Asus Strix comes with around $340. This is by far the best card you are going to find around this price point. Also, two GTX 970 in SLI performs better than its bigger brother, the single GTX 980. Now, let's talk about the problem that people had about the GTX 970. They couldn't use more than 3.5 GB of video memory, or their performance went down when games started to use more than 3.5 GB of video memory. So buying the card, you should be happy with 3.5 GB of video memory. There are those extra 500 MB, but they perform way slower than the rest 3.5 GB of video memory. So when you go to and uses over 3.5 GB, then your in-game performance goes down. This happens due to the cheaper lower quality L2 module that has been used in the 970. The higher quality L2 module is used in the higher card GTX 980. You will not notice the difference if you are not using more than 3.5 GB of video memory. Another information you should take a look at is most games up to now can't use more than 3.5 GB of video memory even at high resolutions. But there are exceptions like the Battlefield 4, which can use more than 3.5 GB at 4K, and all the settings turned to the top. Also, if you want to know the temperature the card ran in, then here it is on the screen. In idle, it ran under 50 degrees Celsius, and under full load, it ran under 70 degrees Celsius. The cause of higher temperature at idle is because of the fans being turned off for silent uses under idle and lower graphic intensive tasks. Of course, you can choose between the silent operation mode and the cooler mode. Let me know your thoughts about the GTX 970 in the comments below. Also, I'd love to hear from you guys what you think about Nvidia releasing wrong higher specifications at the release of the card. But I was happy with the performance the GTX 970 showed, and is a great card with no competitors at all at that price point in performance. If you liked the video, leave a like, or you can like my Facebook page and join my Facebook group, or you can follow me on Twitter, the links are in the description below. Also, if it's your first time to my channel, then I would like you to subscribe for upcoming tech videos, and hopefully I'll see you in my next video. Bye for now.